Are you saying that the Pakistani government is tolerant of the Haqqani?
What I'm saying is that they've been uneven in the pressure that they've applied across this range of groups. What we're trying to do is convince Pakistan that they, too, have a stake in a stable Afghanistan, in a stable region, in reasserting governance over their own territory.
May I interrupt you only because you've been saying that, everybody's been saying that for a long time. What do they say? I mean, as long as you try to convince them, you know, that unless they do something about these territories, then there can be no stability.
You know, I think that they would like, ultimately, a situation where they asserted sovereignty and control over their territory. But they aren't in a position to do that right now. That's one of the things we are trying to help them with in terms of building their own capacity, not only on the military side, but especially on the civilian side, so that there's a government that can actually meet the needs of its people. But this is a long-term project, and they have had, you know, a history of using some different tactics than what we would like to see them doing now. And so this is an ongoing conversation. But we cannot walk away from this. We don't have a choice here. This is a country that is very important to us, that is very important to our success in the region.
Basically, you're saying we have to deal with the Pakistanis because they're too important. Not to.
Absolutely. And there are many areas where we do share common interests and we can work together, and we're going to keep focusing
on those.
What's
our pressure? I mean, what is it? What's our persuasion? Other than saying it's in your interest to do this?
Well, I think that, you know, one of the things the Pakistanis have experienced themselves is that, you know, for Congress to support the level of assistance that we provide to them, both civilian and military, certain expectations have to be met, whether it's cooperation in counterterrorism, whether it's abiding by human rights standards, whether it's dealing with the IMF to make economic reforms. There are things that I think undergird the ability of the international community to support them. And so we are very open in our dialogue with them, being very clear about the kinds of things that are necessary for us to be able to continue our support.
Join us online at charlierose.com.